like to welcome you all here for Killinkere Drama Group staging Pat Clarke's second production, Moments of Madness. There are a few house announcements to be made. In the event of an emergency, there are three exits to your right and also the door at the front of the hall here. I'd like to ask everyone to switch off their mobile phones if they haven't already done so. This is a two-act play with a short interval where there will be a raffle. The bar will also be open during the interval and also at the end of the show. I'd like to welcome members of the Millrace Drama Group and ask for a round of applause for their amazing achievement. On winning the All-Ireland last weekend with their play Trad. Sit back and enjoy Pat's production, Moments of Madness.
Things about you.
Last time I was talking to you, you said you were leaving America and coming home tired and forgotten.
Jesus, is that the last time I was talking to you? Doesn't time fly? I should have made contact sooner. So that must be 6 or 7 years ago, but so you know me, Jimmy.
Well, as good as anyone. Are you staying a while?
Oh, well, perhaps. It's a little bit different than what I was expecting.
It's not very exciting now, is it?
It's got character.
It's got a roof. I'm not so sure about character.
Might have had a look around.
No, go ahead, look away, sir. Me and Jimmy drink a mug of tea.
Sure, if you had to tell me sooner, Flory could have sent over a few things at me.
Ava brought a few things. She picked them up along the way.
Look after them,
Christy. I will.
This place is a bit rough and ready, Christy, but... I think you'll get the hang of it after a while.
We'll see. Do you recognise anyone in the pictures?
I guess this is your family.
Yeah, that one was taken shortly before the mother died.
Oh, she's a nice looking woman.
Oh, that's where I got the good looks from.
Aye, and a good woman too she was. Happy God she hadn't an easy life.
I'd say you're on your father's side, Christy. Would that be you there?
No, that was Patrick that got killed. I was 5 years younger.
Oh, I remember you talking about that.
Ah, the poor gossip. Patty was on his mother's side, a grand gossip. And you, Christy, you are more like old Jaunty. A hell of a good worker now, but a bit on the fiery side.
And him telling me what a nice, quiet young lad he was.
Aye, when his mother was alive. Oh, after she died, I'm afraid the poor man, he didn't have it easy.
It wasn't easy, I don't know, trying to rear two young lads on 10 acres and keep a job going in the shoe factory at the same time.
So he quit the job when the young fella died. You know, he kind of blamed himself. Never was the same after. And you, Christy, you were a hard gossip to mind.
I think I let him down a bit.
Oh, be God, that's putting it mildly. Do you like the photographs?
I love photographs, especially family ones. Do you know, this place is sort of cool, Christy. I think I might have a look around outside. I'll leave you at it.
Aye, go ahead. Be careful out there now, because there's no light on that.
Really?
This man and me are drinking mug of tea anyway.
Well, tell me, Christy. Are you going to stay the night?
I am, Jimmy. The night after. The night after that. After that, I don't fucking know.
Nothing wrong, I hope.
We got fucked out of our house today.
Oh, jeez, it's not an eviction.
That's it. The bank took back the keys.
And were you living near the city?
On the outskirts, actually, we thought we had it all. The big house, the big jobs, the big jeeps. 2 sun holidays a year. Thought we'd never see a poor day again.
The last time you were here, you had Joan and the children with you at your father's funeral.
Oh, she came back with me that time, even though we were living apart. So she liked the old man a lot.
Yeah, he liked her. What the hell happened, Christy?
Maybe I was hard to live with.
I begotten. You know, she was always so polite and friendly.
Oh, no more than the rest of them now. She had her moments, but that's why I didn't want to bring another woman back. I knew she was well got, and I didn't want to have another woman coming about the place.
Oh, I know, it can't be easy.
No, never easy. Never easy coming back. There's a lot of people around here that wish that I'd never showed me face again.
What, do you mean after the night of their football match?
That's it. A wound that never healed.
I don't know, Christy. That's a long time ago, you know, and people forget, you know.
Time will tell. I was just looking about here, Jimmy, and you know, for a house that wasn't lived in for a while, it's not too bad at all.
No, I kept fires going in it all the time, Christy. You know, it was your father's wish. The poor fella. Ah, he used to say, in fact, only a fortnight before he died, he says to me, Jimmy, keep it open, he says. That gossip of mine will come back here again someday.
Funny enough, I didn't intend coming back. Not yet, anyway. Ah, you know the story yourself. It, even as we stood on the road after the eviction, it wasn't the first thing came to mind.
And what was your plans?
Sure, we had no plans. I didn't think the bank would take back the keys. Well, not that quick, anyway. Sure, where would we be going with a couple of €100 to our name?
I know this old place needs a bit of a tidying up, but the land and the garden is in good shape. And now, Christy, you can have the land back straight away now.
You were always far too good of a neighbour. And tell me, Florrie, how is she keeping?
Oh, not too bad at all, apart from those bloody pains. But I can tell you one thing, she can still give out to me.
Is she still baking the cakes?
Happy God you remember the cakes.
So she always sent one home with us every time we went over after the mother died.
Ah, Jesus. She was a great woman. And your mother, thank God she was a powerful cook and a thrifty woman. But tell me, Christy, the job, is it really gone?
Oh, I should have explained, Jimmy. Do you see, I was working with an IT crowd back in the States and they were relocating the plant to Ireland and I was offered a big job and it was too good to turn down.
And when was that, Christy?
Oh, it was 6 or 7 years ago. We came back here and, as I said, the big house and all that stuff took out a huge mortgage.
And what the hell happened?
About 2 years ago, we came into work after Christmas and the company told us they were moving production to India.
Not that quick.
Yeah, we were out of work maybe in about 2 months. We looked about for other jobs in the same kind of field. Could get nothing, and sure, couldn't keep the mortgage paid.
What about herself? What's her name?
Ava.
Ava. Is she from Ireland?
Well, she was born here, but her folks moved to America. They died over there. But she has a sister here living not that far away, but no one can dare.
And are they close?
Well, they speak every day on the phone and that.
Does she know about the trouble?
Oh, Gina, that's her name. Oh, she does, yeah. She wanted us to go down and stay with her for a few days, but I said it wouldn't be an option, so I said no.
Well, now, Christy, you can stay with myself and Florrie tonight if you want.
No, I know that, Jimmy. No, we'll have to try and get used to staying here till we figure out our next move. Please, I better call her in there because God knows what happened to her out here.
Ava! Ava!
Here.
Hi. God, I love those little gardens and the sheds. God, I'd love to have been reared in a place like this.
Were you townie or what?
Oh, no, I wouldn't say a townie now. I'm from the West. I was born in Castlebar, but my parents moved to New York when I was about 15. Never really got to know what country life was like.
You could get to know lots about it now, and the hardship that goes with it, huh? Tell me, Jimmy, thanks for setting up and doing the few bits, but Flory will be wondering where you're gone to. Maybe you'd be as well go home.
Aye, God will, and you know what I do? I'll come over to you tomorrow. And I'll bring a cow over to you tomorrow as well.
I know, I didn't expect that.
Oh, because that was always the plan. A cow would be left with you here for as long as you stayed. Now.
Well, no, thank you, Jimmy. Thanks.
Oh, you're very welcome, Dolphy. You're very welcome.
Looking forward to seeing Flory tomorrow.
Aye, I tell her you were asking for.
Well, do you know, Christy, he seems like a real gentleman.
Ah, they were always great neighbours. Lucky to have him, himself and his wife, Flory.
And any family?
No, very, very good to us as kids. What do you think of the new abode? Not a bit of a come down, huh?
Do you know, Christy, the house needs a bit of work. The garden and the sheds are lovely. But you don't seem so sure, Christy. But then again, you never really talked about home, did you?
Never really wanted to come back. Why? Not such happy memories.
Why?
Ah, the mother dying young, the brother getting killed, and the father trying to cope. Of course, Abe got a bit wild. And things just didn't go well.
Oh, sure. Look at Christy. That's the past. Today we'll turn a new leaf and we'll start afresh. But you know, I'm absolutely exhausted. Do you think we'll sleep there tonight?
Yeah, we moved this up here a few years before he died. It's much warmer up here.
Oh, yeah. But you know, we'll make the bed. Will you give me a hand? Because, you know, I have some fresh sheets and we'll...
Right, but yes, it'll be a tight fit.
We'll be all right, Christy. Don't worry. My God, that's a grand-looking new mattress he had.
Now, myself and Joan bought that from a few years before he died. He didn't like it at the beginning, but then we did. But the end come, he'd got to love it. But I'd say it was never broke in.
But you know, I wonder, will it be springy tonight, Christy?
Why, Jesus, it'll be springy tonight. Get over there, you girl, yeah. You went a bit hard on me. Good morning, Jimmy. How are you?
I'm still overground, as they say about here.
Well, good morning.
Yes, and Flory sent over a lot of things there for you.
Yes, that was good, what? Oh, which is my favourite.
And what is that?
Fresh hen eggs.
Oh, my God.
Aye, and you'll have your own before too long. By the way, I was listening to the radio there this morning and I heard something on it that might concern you.
Would that be the Department of Environment scheme?
Oh, my God, you heard about it.
No, I was on the phone to my sister last night and she told me to check it out. She said it might suit the two of us.
Oh, that's it. She was in there. Flory wrote it down on a piece of paper for me. You see, because that's it, surely.
Yeah.
It's called the Lean, Clean and Green Scheme. It says where 10 couples are selected to manage on a budget of €100 per week for a year, paid by the department. And you'd be, what's that word, assessed.
Yes.
A number of times during the year, and the couple who'd impressed the judging panel the most throughout the year, they'd win a prize of €20,000. Now, I only caught the end of it, but I says to myself, says I, because says I, that'd suit yon pair beyond. I think you should check it out.
Well, if we're going to stay here, we might as well have a purpose, and that sounds good. Maybe, Gina, you check it out when you still have a bit of credit on your phone.
If there is a bit left, Christy.
Would you give us a hand, maybe, Jimmy, to get started?
Oh, God, I most certainly will, Christy. The Kellys were always great neighbours. And I tell you what, Flory will throw her shoulder to the wheel as well now.
And what would you consider, we'd say, priority?
Well, I think the garden, Christy. The garden is priority now. And the first idea that comes, I'll bring your father's little plough and tractor up here and I'll plough that garden for you, because do you know what I'm going to tell you? There wasn't a better bit of ground in Ireland for growing spuds and vegetables.
Well, do you know something, Christy? Wouldn't that be gorgeous to go out every day and bring in our own fresh vegetables?
Aye, and you'll have your own cow, and you'll have your own milk, and you can churn, and have your own butter.
Wow.
Oh, because you'll have buttermilk, you can make your own bread. Should be got all you want then, is a knock of hens and a few ducks. Ah, Christy, the ducks. You remember the dogs your mother used to always have? You remember? You see them every morning and got the tip on down to your liver. And apple trees and fruit trees. I think be God you said made you go.
Well, sir, it's up to myself and you, Ava, to make it work.
It is.
Well, shall we have a toast here on Johnny Kelly's tail?
Oh, and I can tell you, I'd better get back to me old flurry. She wasn't feeling that well this morning.
No.
And listen, why don't you just come over to see us, honey?
Well, do you know, Jimmy, I'd love to meet your wife, and thank you again for everything.
You're very welcome.
So good.
You're very welcome, Donna.
Jimmy, maybe I'd go and take a look at the garden and the sheds and see what...
Come on ahead with me. Come on and see you later.
All right. No bother.
Woman. I say you must be Christie's woman.
Well, I'm Christie's partner, and who are you?
I'm Nigel Monaghan. I say I'm Nigel Monaghan from down the road. Harris sent me over here with a few hints for you. It was him that was telling me the story about you.
And what story would that be now?
You just were fired out of the house in Dublin. I say you were fucked out.
Well, now... I don't think Jimmy would have said anything like that.
Well, it mightn't have been exactly like that, but it was something like that.
Well, it was nice you to bring the hens in, it was.
I'll bring you over a cock later. You know, you need a good cock one with them hens. A good cock will tip at least two of them a day.
And come here, what do you work at yourself?
Me? Oh, I'm ferocious busy at home.
So you know my Christy?
Christy Kelly! I say Christy Kelly! Yep. I knew him before he went off to America. He was a wee bit older than me, you know. Used to see him at home with the other one.
And did you ever meet him?
No, never set eyes on her. A good-looking woman she was. I say a good-looking woman she was. As me father used to say, he was a lucky hooer to get her.
As if she was too good for me, you're trying to say.
Well, sir, you can take whatever meaning you like, I'm sure.
I wonder, will they say the same thing about me?
Well... Oh, I don't know. What would I know? Did you know old Johnny here?
No, I didn't. Only what Christy used to tell me about him.
Well, I'll tell you. He was as thick and an awkward a boy as you ever laid eyes on him, but a ferocious hard worker. He had his fair share of troubles round here.
We won't talk any more about that now. It was nice you to bring the hens, and you can leave them outside the back door, and my Christy will house them when he's ready.
I hear you're going to make a go of this place.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you, you'll have your work cut out for you. This country's fucked. I say, this country's fucked.
Bye-bye.
I'll leave them outside.
You do that.
Say around here, Ava. Now you're sucking, Diesel. I hope you get a bit of butter off and all that churn in your app.
Go away on that, Christy Kelly. I've loads. It's fantastic.
You know, I still can't believe we got accepted for that scheme.
Oh, and me neither. And the only couple in the county. Do you know, I think it was meant for us, Christy. Do you know, do you miss the big house, the big job, and the big jeep?
Bring me bollocks, huh? This is a great thing. Not that I have to get a bit of work done in this garden today.
Well, do you know, Christy, now you'd want a waterproof jacket if you'd gone out in that weather today, so you would.
Well, I was just looking here at the coat rack, and there's one here belonging to the old man if he could do the job.
Right.
This one here, do. There's something heavy in it. Oh, you know me and the whiskey.
Oh, me chooses. I know you and the whiskey. We'll keep that for the visitors.
Aye. Am I all right here with the sleeve?
Yeah.
I am.
But you know something, that's a fine, sensible jacket. And a good fit. Yourself and your father wish we'd same your size, Christy.
Indeed we were, but the same. What is he here?
What?
Oh, Jesus. He must have been saving for a rainy day.
Oh, well, I don't believe it. It's a rainy day and Christy Kelly finds a load of money.
I knew he was saving to bring a few radiators and he was going to convert a back bedroom into a bathroom.
We can do that now, Christy.
But I don't think we'd be allowed to under the terms of the scheme.
You see?
Well, I don't know. But you know what we should do? We should look around and see if there'd be any more money in
there. I know, I wouldn't think so. The old man wouldn't have much. But you know, I can't put this into a bank or the credit union.
Well, you be careful with that money now, Christy Kelly.
Well, I'll be careful with it. And I'll be careful with you too. Get
that thing!
Hello? Oh, hello! Oh, hello, Gina! Oh, God, the scheme has gone great! Oh, yeah, I'm so happy, Gina! And Christy? Oh, I've never seen Christy happier. He's in great form. When are you going to come up and stay a night? Oh, I know. That is a bit of a problem. We're still sleeping in the living room. And a small bit confined for space. But, you know, it sort of has its fun aspect as well, Gina. Oh, and you know what we got? We got this portable shower. Now, it's a bit awkward, but it works, and we're clean. Do you know, Gina, what I was thinking of checking out? The local farmer's market. I was thinking of putting a stall in and see if it works. Okay, love, I won't hold you. I know you're busy. Regards to them all. And the children and all, are they well? Okay, love. We'll talk soon. Hope to see you soon, Gina. Bye-bye, darling. Bye-bye. Christian Lovely. But you know, Christian, I'm so fascinated with your man's little box of goodies here. All these wonderful recipes. Do you know I'm after finding one for potato bread and boxing, and I can't wait to give it a go.
So we were too young to understand how good she was. Didn't you often hear Harris talking about?
Well, I know now what he was talking about. All these recipes so neatly tucked away in the little copybooks. And there's another thing, Christy. Did your mother write poems?
She could have had, but we were too young to understand.
But you know, the writing looks the same as the recipes. I'd say it's hard. Will I read you a little one?
Aye, fire ahead.
It's called Alone in My Purple Hall. Yet in the eye of my memory, I see the mountain still and the silence deep that's held. The soft green-coated hills. I see the swallow dive and I hear the curlew call. Yesterday, when I sat and watched, alone in my purple hall. Isn't that lovely? And then, Chrissy, when I was looking through, I found as well the memorial cards. One of Lily Kelly, aged 42 only, and then little Patrick, aged 13.
I had always a tough time on the old man, you know. I was too young and didn't understand. I just about remember the excitement of Patrick's funeral. The crowds and the cakes and the buns and all that.
I know, it was a hard time. What's that you're reading, Christy?
An interesting book, it's called Moments of Madness. It's kind of reminds me of our own situation. It's actually the one you got from the library from the other day.
Well, it looks like a good read.
It's all about ordinary people making rash decisions and how it can change their lives forever.
Oh, a bit like us.
You could say that. The one I'm reading about now is about a man that went in, won £1,000 on a raffle in England, and went in and put on a full round of the Premiership, and come back and won £250,000 on the whole lot.
Oh, crazy kind of stuff.
His only bet ever.
Oh, well. And then he probably went off and lost it all.
Never got on another bet again. He now owns a chain of bookie shops in England, but now they're not all good stories. Isn't it amazing the twists and turns that can take place in a person's life?
Well, do you know, Christy, we can understand that now.
We certainly can.
Do you know?
Jesus, it's too wet about there that
it
day.
It is. It doesn't look like a day for working outside. But you know, Christy, I was wondering, you said the first wet day they came, you might try out the old record player.
Oh, this machine. Do you know I was looking at it this morning and the red light came on anyway?
Did it?
I just about remember my father bringing this home one day. One Christmas when we were very small. My mother, I think, loved music. She had a nice voice. Used to sing to us when she'd be putting us to bed. This is working anyway. I'm not so sure now with the condition of the vinyl records.
I can't stop loving.
That's the famous Jim Reeves.
I never heard of Jim Reeves.
Famous American singer. He was killed in an air accident.
It's a nice song.
You know, when we were younger, there was three pictures over the mantelpiece here. John Paul the 23rd, the Pope, JFK, he's still up there, and Jim Reeves. Yes, we were simple people back then.
That is a bit for my time, Christian.
You're only a young one. It would be dangerous getting in beside you there.
Well, do you know, it might be bush. We have all day for that. Do you know, I'm dying for a shower. Do you think that you organise it for me?
So I'll just...
I was checking the water here when I was making the tea. It's near enough right. That's about perfect. Are you ready?
No, no, wait now, Christy, because I'll tell you. The last time you told me that, you nearly scalded me.
Check it there yourself.
There.
Go on, get soaked up and shampooed up. Because I'll tell you, I'll pour it into this yoke here. I'm getting ready to spray it from here. What about an old dance? I'm going to get ready to spray.
Well, you spray, Christian, because I can't dance now.
I hope you're all ready for it.
I'm ready. Start pulling. Do you know what I'm washing now, Christian?
I know what you're washing now.
And how do you know what I'm washing now, Christian?
I'm going to help you up and down on you, and I hope because I'm all out of water, so I hope you're clean. Now, you want more?
No, I'm done. I'm done. I'm done. Would you give me a towel?
How the fuck did you get in?
How did I get in? How the fuck do you think I got in?
Was the door not locked? Jesus, I
must Christy, have... you told me that door was locked.
I went out for a piss and I must have forgot to put the latch on the door.
Well, don't mind me. I say, don't mind me. I brought you a cock for them hens. I tell you, you need a good cock runner with them. A good cock, a tip, at least two of them a day.
Christy, I don't understand her speak.
It's Cully Handler speak. She'll get used to it, won't she, Max?
She will. The cock that gets up at six does the business. I say he does the business. That's why all the men around here are early risers. They're all crowing at six.
Not me, Max.
Would you mind stepping outside that door until I finish my shower?
I'll tell you, if you don't quit looking at your one in the shower there, you'll be rising at six. I say you'll be rising at six.
Maybe you may as well tip along.
I'll leave the cock outside.
Bring the cock with you, Mags. They're hard cough from what I hear. You know what's good about this, Mike? You'll be the first woman in Ireland with a bicycle stand in a farmer's market and a boot sale. It'll be a novel idea.
I know. God, I'm excited, but I'm a bit nervous as well, Christian.
Look, I think when they read the leaflet that you have explaining all about the scheme that they'll be very impressed. Mind you, you look good too.
Didn't so?
Mike, don't overload it now on your first visit.
Oh, no, no, I won't. But I was wondering, what do you think all this would say we'd get with us?
You have a shawl and you have lots of vegetables, you have jam, you have butter, flour. Are you tight in €50 with the whole lot?
Oh, geez, that'd be brilliant. I could get a few bits for the house.
You don't spend it all now in the one shop.
Oh, no, only if I get a bargain. You know me, Christy. But you know, it's an awful pity Jimmy isn't here to see us off.
Well, I asked him and Flory to come over.
Amateur. Look, if it goes well today, there'll be more days.
Have you got it, Ava?
Tell
me, sorry, I meant to be over earlier. Oh, be God, they're looking great. Oh, that's a great outfit altogether. And the flowers, oh, they're fantastic.
From our garden. I thought Florrie'd like to come over and see you.
No. She wasn't feeling too well. She went back to the bed.
Oh, I'm sorry to you. She's not well, Jimmy.
Oh, the devil of bother is on her. It's only now how she has there for the last couple of days. But listen, Ava, the very best of luck to you with that.
Jeez, I think the whole thing is catchy.
Oh, God, it is now. There's no doubt about it.
Well, now, boys, I'm going to head off because I want to set up this stall early and make a few pounds today for me and Christy.
Best of luck to you, darling.
God bless you.
Yeah,
tell her out there and I'll put on a mug of tea for you, Jim.
Hello.
Hello, Jimmy. I think we'll get to there, lad.
There's no doubt about it, but I'll get them there. And you know something else? That little woman is blooming on the whole blessed thing. And you know, he's look awful happy, the pair is.
Well, now the first 6 months was hard enough. But we're nearly self-sufficient now.
Ah, me good young Kelly. You know, I always said you'd make it. You know, your poor old father, he used to say to me, Jimmy, I prayed every night that that gossip would come home. You know, he didn't like the idea of the old place being closed up after he was gone.
Well, sure, we used to come over a lot back when I was married, and but then, you know, Joan, she would have loved this place and she loved the old man, but when we split up, things changed. So I think he blamed me for it.
Aye, he did. I didn't like that woman, Joan.
Oh, I know he did, and in fairness, she was and is a good enough woman. She never knew the trouble that I caused about here.
Nah, Christy, when you were a young gossip, you know, you were grand, but then after the mammy died, you went a bit on the wild side.
And I know, Jimmy, you were never really into the football about here, but I'm sure you've heard about the night of the semi-final when I nearly killed that young short.
Ah, look at Christy, I know what you did was wrong. And sure, you could have killed him from what I hear anyway.
That's why I never got too involved with anyone from my comeback. But I was planning in my head that maybe one of these days I'd meet up with that short lad and maybe finally make the peace.
Cost you a good lot of money now, Christy.
Cost old Jaunty Kelly a lot of money, sure I had not. It was stupid stuff, and all over a woman that'd suit neither of us.
But you know, Christy, that's so long ago now that people have forgotten all that.
15 long years.
And does Ava know about it, by the way?
Well, I don't think she knows, but she suspects that something very wrong happened in the past. Joan used to bring up me dark side whenever we'd have a row. I think someone told her.
How is? How's only passing?
Thanks.
Tell us, Christy, how is your cop doing? Is he going early at 6? I said, does he get up at 6?
He does, but Ava doesn't be that keen.
Oh, some women don't like the early crow. I say they don't like the early crow.
I didn't see you in an age, Mags. She's curtain.
Curtain? I hadn't a good feckin' curtain in my life and I'm hardly gonna start now.
Better late than never, Mags.
Never mind now, Christy. Not 12 months ago she was curtain that young lad of A.B. Gaffney's.
The young lad at home?
Aye.
A good catch, Mags.
I thought that too. I may have had a dance one night, and he walked me home. I say he walked me home.
That was a start. Did you bring him in?
No. I brought him to the hay shed. I brought him into the hay shed. You see, I never had a cook before, and I thought he'd be able to show me how.
Oh, be gone. Gaffney is the boy that'll show you.
Well, I tell you, he hadn't a fucking clue. Buttons on his waistcoat and he says to me, I don't think me mammy'd like that. Maybe we'll leave it for another night.
Did you kiss him at all?
Kiss him? I think he thought that God only gave him the fucking tongue to lick the dinner plates. I say, to lick the fucking dinner plates.
What did you tell him?
Oh, I tell him to fuck away off home to his mama. And a fair bit of fun watching yon cock out there tipping the hay. I'll better be off. And
don't live in his long again, Max.
Here, how's your gander?
The next time you're over, Max, I'll give you Magus points.
Aye, that'll do, lovely. I'll all see you.
All the best, Max.
Look, let yourself out, Max.
Take it easy. God, she's a gas woman.
Is she still at home with that man?
Oh, indeed she is. Ah, from the mother died, you know. Ah, sure. She never moved out from doubtfully, you know. And the devil a bit where I go now. You know, he's moving on.
So are we all.
Ah, come on, Christy, you're only a gossip. But, speaking of which, Florrie was just asking me, how is your new scheme going?
Well, not so bad. I forgot to tell you, here a couple of weeks ago, we were, they came about and interviewed the two of us. Spent about 2 hours, went through all our records. I think they were very impressed. Said that they'd let us know the result in 2 or 3 months.
Just would be great if you got it, wouldn't it?
Sure we'd have been at nothing only for yourself and Florrie.
Ah, myself and Florrie, me foot, not at all. No more than good neighbours would do. And speaking of Florrie, I'll have to get back, Christy. I'm afraid Florrie wasn't feeling that well this morning.
All right, shall we talk to you later, Jimmy?
All right, Christy. Mind yourself.
Don't bother. We'll tidy this place up before she comes back.
I'll tell you, he was well impressed with the bicycle stall and the CLG. He couldn't have been nicer. He bought everything there, the butter. And the only reason he bought the butter is because I think he said he had gallstones and he wouldn't use it. But another woman bought that, and she would have bought twice as much if we had it.
That's all the milk we have, but so maybe we get another cow.
Well, we could do that. Wait, I tell you, didn't the priest say he'd come down and bless the house some night?
Oh, I'm not sure, Eva. I'm getting on not too bad about here now without any involvement from the church. I wouldn't trust any.
Ah, well, no, Christy. Anyway, look, he bought everything and I'm sure he'd do the same again. He was a lovely man. I'd say you'd like him.
Well, tell me this. Show me what you have or what kind of profit did you get for the day?
Well, I'll tell you, I took in 55 euro and I'd spent 15, Christy.
Jesus, that's fairly good going. You've some hip of stuff home for 15 euro.
Haven't I? I'll tell you, I picked the flowers and the blackberries and that on the way home. And I got that throw there. That was 3 euro.
Is that a draft board, I see?
Well, it is, Christian. I remember you saying you should love to play the old drafts for a young lady. So I got over 2 euro.
I'll throw them out here and we'd have a game.
No. Are you sure?
I'm sure, why not?
Well, do you know, Christian Kelly, it's something else. Imagine, it's 4 o'clock on a Friday afternoon, and here's the pair of us. Playing drafts.
Oh, this is what I call chilling out. Maybe. I suppose we probably should be drinking a sup of tea too, but we're all right. Yeah, you're going red and I'm going black, is that the...
That's the story.
Now, I'll give you the first
piece. Now, I'd say you will beat the living daylights out of me.
Now, I love the drafts. Ah, fuck you, I thought you said you never played before.
Well, you know, I'm one of those snakes and louds or drafts you played
before. Well, don't you worry, I'll beat you yet. Well, fuck you again, you'll have to beat me again. You know what it is? I think I'm getting a bit rusty at this stuff.
Well, I don't know now, Christy Kelly. I think you might be getting a bit rusty at other things too.
Oh, you bold brat, you. I never heard any complaints. Listen, nothing. I'll play you a couple of games when I come in, but I better go out and milk this cow and do a few other bits. Is that all right?
That's no bad.
That lovely fancy car outside, and you scared me the way that you drove so fast up to the door.
All these eggs in one day?
Well, you know, we usually have more, Gina. We've 12 hens now.
This is great. I love what I see so far. It's even better than I expected. But what I really love is the gardens coming in.
Listen, Gina, we'll have a better look around later. Would you like a glass of wine?
Yeah, go on.
But come on, sit down.
So is Christy away?
Hello, Gina. He's just popped down to the local man there, Jimmy Harris. We're going to have a look at a bag of turf that his dad owned in the local bog.
Oh, the whole thing's so novel. How is this scheme going?
The CLG?
Yeah, yeah. The C is for country, the L is for what, and the G is for green.
Well, do you know now, it's like it's tailor-made for us.
No money and a lot of fun.
Well, no, Gina. I wouldn't say that. We get 100 euro a week for participating in it. And we take in 40 at the market. And you know, we live on less.
That sounds nearly too good.
Well, almost that, Gina. And tell me, had you any trouble finding here?
No, I drove into the village and I came out the begging road. I inquired of a girl on the side of the road. Oh, she seemed to know both of you.
What did she look like?
She was smallish, dark-haired. She spoke kind of funny, I thought.
Oh, do you know, it was Meg's mother. Oh, well, Meg's was always on the road. Do you know, she's not a bit out of skin. It was her that gave us the eggs. Do you know, but she loves the gossip. But sure, that's the country, Gina. I'm so used to it now.
So, all things aside, how are you doing, Ava?
Oh, God, not too bad now. But you know, it just hasn't been an easy road for me.
I guess it's different for Christy. He was reared here. It must be a lot easier for Christy.
Oh, I don't know, Gina. Sometimes it looks like it's home to me, not Christy.
Why do you say that?
Oh, God, Gina, there's a side to Christy that's hard to figure out. Like, the place is great, he works it well, but there's times he just seems so distant amid his own people and his neighbours.
Well, I remember when you first returned from the States, you talked about leaving him then.
Oh, that was a terrible time, Gina. Do you remember all that hassle? The wife and the boys in the States. But then, you know, we got the good job and it was secure and everything seemed to turn around for us and we were beginning to be happy.
And now?
Oh, Gina, there's a side to Christy. He's just always on edge. It scares me.
Not abusive?
No, not abusive, Gina.
Now you would tell me, wouldn't you?
Oh, I would, darling. Of course I'd tell you. But listen, there's enough about me. Tell me about you.
Oh, you know us, busy. John's working away, nothing new there, and the boys, they're getting so big. They're mad into their hurling and rugby. Actually, I have to get back to take Jack to a game this evening.
Oh, what time is it? I'll see you won't be staying.
Next time, I may stay over. Look it, I better stop drinking this wine, or the only place I'll be staying is in some cell. So how's these markets going?
Oh, the market's going great, Gina. That is going great, yeah?
And what about this priest?
Oh, Father Willie. Oh, yeah. He's gorgeous. And you know he's meant to be coming round to bless the house one of the evenings. Can't wait.
Oh, Gina!
Stay.
I was trying to figure out the car outside. It's kind of strange to see a car outside this house.
Oh, yeah, we only got it in the past few weeks. And we love the Lexus.
Looks like a nice car. Is it the new model?
Yeah, I think so. I just drive it. So how are you doing, Christy?
Not too bad at all, Gina. You look good too. Indeed, you're nearly as young looking as your older sister.
That's a compliment.
Yeah, I guess Christy can't decide which one of the two hoey girls is better looking.
No, you haven't. That's it, Gina. Hello? Mick? Oh, yeah. No, I knew it was you. Yeah. No, I didn't leave the house yet. No, I don't intend to miss it. May it's 50th. Hold on one second. Ava, I was thinking, I know it's late, but maybe they'll shoot up to Dublin for Mick's 50th. But maybe stay the night.
Oh, sure. Christy, I was expecting you to do that anyways. Not at all. You tell him. Go on, carry on and talk to him. You do that. I'm going to show Jean outside, okay?
No bother. Yeah, Mick. Okay. Yeah, that's no bother, but you know the story with me and the driver. Yeah. If I got the bus in about, what, half an hour, you could maybe pick me up at Plum Corner? Right. Looking forward to seeing all the lads. After getting drunk for me, it'd be a new experience. Right, looking forward to it. Listen, I have to run because Ava's sister Jean is here with us. I'm sure I forgot you know her from work. Right, no bother, I'll chat to you later. Jesus, listen.
Sorry it took so long to get here. The parish always has me so busy.
Oh, God, Willie, you're welcome. I'm sorry about the state of the place and myself. I wasn't expecting anyone to see.
Not at all, Evie. You're fine. You know, it's great to see the old side washing.
Oh, it's all we can afford.
And himself.
Oh, Christy. Oh, Christy's gone away for the night. The first time since we moved here. Our friend of his was 50 and invited him to the party.
And left you at home.
Oh, but you know, to be honest with you, I didn't really know the chap. It was someone he knew from his younger days, and I'm just as happy potting around here. Now, I leave this and let you get on with
it. Not at all, Eva. Carry on. Finish it out. I tell you what, I'll give you a hand.
Oh, you will not. Oh, no, no, Father Willie. This is my own stuff, really.
Oh, no, sure, I used to have. Sure, I used to help the mother with it when I was younger.
Well,
I used to always do the ringing.
That was a bit different now, Father Willie.
With three sisters and no brothers, Eva. No different at all, really.
And would they not help your mother with that type of stuff?
Well, do you know, I can't really remember now. They were all a lot older than me. They probably did it when they were younger.
Will you do the ringing, son?
Well, of course I will, Eva. And do you know what? Just call me Willie.
Do you know, this is a bit weird.
Well... As I said, Eva, it's not my first time to handle ladies' underwear.
But you were younger then, Willie, and I'm sure your sister's underwear is a bit different to mine.
Well, now, sure, don't they all do the same thing?
Oh, they do. You know, this is great for taking out the heavy stains.
Well, now you're definitely beginning to sound like my mother now. She said it was great for the colours of the shirts. I'm sure it's lovely to see it.
Is it your first time here?
Yeah, the old man was,
Oh, Jonty, and the mother died, Joe.
Yeah, well, Jonty died a short time before I got to the parish, so I never knew any of them, really.
All right, well, look, we're done now.
Well, good. Many hands make light work, as they say.
Oh, indeed it does, as long as Meg's Monaghan doesn't arrive.
Oh, so you know Meg's?
Oh, I know Meg's. God, she's some character, isn't she? She goes to church, does she?
I'll tell you, and confession.
Oh, that should be called that twice as long.
So you're getting to know all the neighbours, then?
I am. Do you know, it's taken a while. But the farmer's market helped great, so it did.
And you have the place looking lovely, I have to say.
Oh, well, not too bad. Do you know, would you like a cup of tea now that you're here?
Do you know what, Eva? I won't. I had tea just before I left the house.
Would you like a drink?
What have you?
Well, I've wine.
Lovely.
I've a nice bottle of red wine here that I got at the farmer's market.
But do you know what? I love that wine. But I'd buy it myself the other time.
Ah, dear.
So, tell me about your situation.
Oh, well, do you know, Father Willie, we headed on, lost it all, and ended up here with nothing.
I know, Eva, I wouldn't say nothing. I mean, you have each other, and as I said, this certainly seems a cosy little place.
Well, to be honest with you, Father, I do love it here. Yeah, I do.
And this scheme you're involved with?
Oh, the CLG, Clean, Lean, Green programme. God, it's going great for us.
And Christy?
Oh, well, you see, Father, Christy was married in America to a lady called Joan. And they're two boys, and then they separated about 8 years ago.
Well, as people do, especially over there.
Yeah, and then myself and Christy was working for the same company in New York, and actually we started dating around that time, and then as luck had it, we got a job transfer back here to Ireland. I'm sure everything was going great. We sort of had it all, Father Willie. We had the big job, the big house, the big jeeps, holidays, and everything was wonderful. And then the company changed production to India, and we lost it all.
Oh, well, let's not talk about that now. I mean, but you're getting on well at the moment.
I am. I love it here, Willie. Jeez, you know, Father, I'm after St. Willie without even thinking. Jeez, that must be so at ease, or it must be the good wine.
Well, you can't beat the good wine. And Christy, I mean, after all, this is home for him.
Ah, it is, but you know, I don't know. It sometimes feels more like home to me. Christy can be hard at times. I wonder about him, really.
I see. And is he older than you?
He's a little older, all right. But now, you know, I better stop drinking this wine, and you better bless this house.
God, it wasn't that way I came. You know, it's nice to be asked, and you know, there's not a lot of couples don't do it anymore, and you know, that's a shame. It's It's a pity Christy can't be here.
Oh, well, do you know now, Father, I don't know about that. We had a bit of a problem with a priest in the past and...
Oh, not abuse, I hope.
Anne? No, not at all. No, Christy was probably something silly.
Well, you know, he needs to be taken gently, Eva. Do you know, I've just been thinking there that that's a really lovely name, Eva. How do you spell it?
E-A-B-H-A. I think it's the Irish for Eve. And Willie?
Oh, well, no compliments, you know, just different versions, really. I mean, I was christened William, but I've been called Willie, Billy, Dick. Lately now, it's, you know, it's usually just Father Willie. Or Willie to you, Eva. Now, brought the holy water and all here, you see? I have a lovely little prayer that I use on these occasions.
You know, the Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen. God bless this house and all who dwell in it. God bless all those who have gone before. God bless Christy's mother and his father.
And his brother.
And his brother. And God grant all who live here long life, happiness and peace. Amen.
Well, do you know, that was gorgeous. Thanks very much.
It's no problem. And do you know, when I am here, I just step outside and I bless the sheds and that cow.
Oh, do you, be careful now. There's no light out there.
I'll be fine.
Careful, Willie.
Careful.
That
that's no problem at all. Listen, I suppose I'd better be getting back. I mean, you never know who might be looking for me.
Do you know, before you go, can I ask you something?
Of course you
do. Confessions. When do you do confessions?
Well, we do have confessions in the church, you know, every Saturday at 12. But, like, really, I mean, you can organise confessions for any time you like or any place.
So you mean I could have confessions here?
Well, if you wanted to.
I'd like it, but I'd be a bit nervous.
Oh, you'd be grand. I tell you what, you go sit over there and prepare, and when you're ready, come and kneel beside me. So, when you're ready, Eva.
I can't believe how comfortable I am about this, and it's years since I was in confessions. Bless me, Father, for I have sinned many times, and I've hurt some people. And you know, Father, I feel guilty about Christy's wife, Joan, having to bring up those two boys on her own in America. Do you know what I'm trying to say?
I do, Eve, I do. But you don't have to feel bad. I mean, it wasn't because of you this split up, was it?
No, it wasn't.
So you and Christy, like, you're happy together?
Oh, I think I've made a big mistake with Christy. I don't know.
And are you in love?
Love, that's a funny one. There's times you're more in love with the place than the men.
So, do I detect you're having a problem with the relationship?
Oh, I don't know, Father Willie. I just think that Christy wasn't too nice to his wife. And I'm scared that sometimes the same thing will happen to me.
Has it been bad to you?
Oh, no, not bad. But he has a temper that scares me. And on one occasion, oh, it was very scary.
Well, no man should hit a woman, Eva. And if he does, you should tell someone.
I will. Do you know, Father Willie, is it a sin to have feelings for another person?
Not at all, Eva. I mean, we all have feelings. It's the way God made us.
Even priests?
Oh, yes. Even priests. Even poor Willie.
Well, do you know, Father, there's someone I've met lately, and I think I've fallen madly in love.
A he, I presume?
Oh, it's a he.
I see. And does this man...
I don't think he realises.
I wonder who the lucky man is.
Well, do you know, I'd love to tell you, but it'd be a bit awkward.
You're a sweet girl, Eva. We're nearly finished now. Just say an act of contrition for me now, please.
Oh, my God, I am truly sorry for my sins, and with your help, I will not sin again.
In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Go in peace. Don't sin again.
Oh, thank you. I'm really pleased with that.
Well, you know, Eva, confessions are still important. You know, they clear the conscience.
And the chest.
Indeed. Anyway, Eva, I'd better be getting back.
Ara, look it. There's only a little drop left. Will we finish it up?
Sure, I suppose. I suppose if you insist, who am I to say no?
Well, do you know something? I mightn't have got close to the church tonight, but I got close to the priest, and that's a good start. Do you know?
It sounds like you picked the right way, so then.
Well, it does. Can I be blunt with you?
But of course you can,
really.
Eva.
Did you ever have sex with a priest?
Well, no. But I'm currently considering it.
And I wonder who that lucky woman is.
Well, you know, Eva, it's at times like these that a priest's celibacy is tested. But listen, I definitely better be going.
Do you know, Father, Willie, or can I call you Will? I hope someday, Will.
You mean?
I don't mean.
Now, you're on your own tonight.
Yeah.
Well, I hope you'll be okay.
Well, if I get a bad thought or a scare, could I ring you? I wonder would that be considered a sick call?
Well, I suppose it could, now. I mean, a good priest definitely shouldn't take any chances.
Well, listen, thank you for a lovely evening, for the blessing, the confession, and your care.
You're very welcome, Eva. No, we'll talk again soon.
Good night.
Good night now, Eva.
Night, Billy.
Night.
Night. Bye-bye. Who's that?
Oh, thank God, it's you.
Ava, are you okay? I mean, you were scared. You look scared.
Oh, I was scared. I was. And you know, for a minute, I thought it was you messing.
I wouldn't do that, Ava. And you in bed.
Yeah. Would you stay a little while with me?
Well, I suppose I could stay for an hour or two, maybe, and you know, wait till you get to sleep, and then I could like let myself out.
Oh, thank you. Oh, do you know, there's a comforting feel after you've been here, Father.
It's definitely times like these that a priest's celibacy is tested.
I'd say it is.
Now, listen, don't let me sleep. I have an early mass in the morning.
There'll be no sleeping tonight, Father.
Fishing, it'll only bring back bad memories.
Like what, Christian?
Oh, I prefer not to talk about Ava. I do hope the window. You know, the old man there was the captain the last time they won the final.
I know, and sure you played yourself.
Aye. Listen, you better head on that bike. I don't think that, and be careful, Emma, I don't think that old scheme allows for big hospital bills.
Oh, well, I can't wait. I'm so excited. It's so long since I was on a bicycle. But I told my friend Jan I'd meet her down at the church cross in about 10 minutes. I'll tell you, I shall be about 2 hours gone, Christy. I hope you have a good day fishing. Enjoy yourself, though, okay?
See you, Pat. Bye, Pat. Take care. Mind yourself on the hard bike. Oh, Jesus. Hope to get another crack in a county final. The Cardinal think it's strange that I didn't go and meet up with him. The things that a man does that lives to regret for the rest of his life. The memories that just won't pass. Now, how am I going to get this fucking thing working? Suppose if I switch it on and that's been years, I always know.
Up goes Smith from Colliandra Gales and McAloo from Ballyvay. McAloo catches it cleanly and passes it across the field to the lively number 10, McGinnity. He pretends to go right, then left. Steadies himself and sends the ball over the bar as he scores yet another glorious point to make the sides level at 10 points apiece.
The game must have started early.
What a county final we have today. Many thought that Ballyvay United would have too much strength and experience for this Gael side, but that is not the way it's turning out. I feel a goal will settle the outcome, but will that goal come as Donny Mac places the ball for the kick out?
For fuck's sake!
And the ball goes between the posts to leave 2 points in it now.
2 points to who? 2 points to fucking who?
This could be real trouble for Colliandra now, as McGinnity steals the ball on the 40-metre line with only the full-back Mahan and Donny Mac in goals to beat. McGinnity cheekily chips the full-back. Runs onto the ball with only the goalkeeper to beat. He's on the 20-metre line. He sends a low shot to the corner, but somehow, Donny Mac gets a touch and puts it around the post at the expense of a 45. What a save. That could have been game, set and match. A 5 points lead with only 7 minutes remaining.
Sick.
The ball is off the upright and goes between the posts to put Ballyvay into a 1 point lead with 3 minutes left in the game. Somehow I feel there's a lot of football still to be played as both sets of supporters get behind their teams. Donny Mac places the ball for the kick out. I spoke to Donny on the way in today. He said after playing 15 years, he would love to win a county medal. He strikes the ball and sends it long and high. Up goes Dalton, catches it cleanly, passes it to his midfield partner, John Black, who lets fly with an almighty kick. It lands on the 13-metre line. Out comes the keeper. He gets the ball, but he's dropped it. What has he done? He should have the ball cleared. Young Johnny Kelly coming racing through. He blocks the goalkeeper's attempt at clearance. Young Kelly tries to get past Smith with an open goal in front of him. Smith drags him down. What else could he do? This is double trouble for Ballybay.
off in the last couple of fucking minutes.
And the referee points to the spot. The referee calls over the Ballyvay keeper, Smith. This could be a red. In fact, yes, it is a red for the goalkeeper. One would have to feel sorry for Maxie Smith. He was damned if he did, and possibly damned if he didn't. The Cullyandra players gather around the ball. Captain Jim Dalton comes over and gives the ball to young Johnny Kelly to take the penalty. Usually a great kicker of dead balls, but he did miss a penalty in the semi-final. He places the ball, moves back about three steps, looks towards the heavens, comes up, strikes the ball. It's a goal! It's a goal for Cullyandra. And what a fitting way this would be for Cullyandra to win this final. Johnny Kelly's uncle, Owl Johnny as he was known then, was the captain of the last team who won the final 45 years ago. He also, on that day, scored the crucial goal that won the game.
For Jesus' sake, radio!
The referee has called for the ball and the game is over. Yes, the game is over and Cullyandra Gaels have won their first junior football championship title in 45 years. Scenes of jubilation as the supporters crowd onto the pitch and carry young Johnny shoulder high. Owl Johnny's son Christy played for many years and was the man of the match in the semi-final 15 years ago as they last qualified for the final. But sadly for him and the Gaels, something happened that night. Let's say there was an incident late into the night. Somebody got badly injured and Christy Kelly never played again. But that was yesteryear.
What the fuck? That was yesteryear. Bringing up that shite and half the county tuned in. If I was near him, I'd break his fucking neck. Me talking shite like that and me here with Ava trying to start a new life. If she hears about it, she'll leave me. I know she will. How will I keep it from her? Fucking bastard. Bastard! Oh, it's a good game. It's even a good game for the club.
Christy, what's wrong? Did you lose the fight?
No, we won it. I just got a bit excited, that's all.
But Christy, you don't look happy. Will you tell me what's wrong? Do you know what you should have done? You should have gone to the game and met up with your local people and your neighbours.
Give it a miss. Take the rod and I'll go down to the lake.
Christy Kelly. You have drink to me. I knew it.
No, I'll take the rod and I'll...
Christy! What's wrong with you? You shouldn't do things like that!
When I'm angry, I'll do what I fucking like. And if I want to go to the lake with or without a rod, that's what I'll fucking do.
Christy, come back here! Hello? Hello. Who's this? No. Christy Kelly isn't here. No, you're who? PRO? Oh, public relations. Yeah. What are you saying you want to apologise for something that happened at the game? Sure, didn't you win it? Oh, something that happened at the commentary. Oh, look, I don't know what's wrong here. I come in. Christy is so angry. He's gone down to the lake. Listen, when he comes in, I'll tell him. I don't really understand what this is all about. Okay, thank you. Thanks. Bye-bye. Bye.
Moment for the charm.
Oh, thanks, Christy. Listen, come on. Sit down, rest yourself. You're always working.
You know, I still can't believe, Ava, that we've actually won the National Award outright.
Oh, me neither. It just won't sink in. You better lodge that cheque, Christy. Just imagine, 20,000. God, I'll tell you, that couple from Galway were fierce disappointed. You know, she was telling me there that they broke some small rule towards the end and it cost them dearly. And they put in a big effort, Christy.
Well, now, darling, I think so did we, and I think we deserved it all. Funny enough, I'm very surprised that the old phone hasn't been ringing.
Honest, Todd, sure, Jimmy and Flory were on earlier. They heard it on the first news, and of course, then herself, Meg's Monaghan, landed at the back door. Did but for know? Once, she didn't come in, thank God. Yeah.
What's that phone?
It's over in the dresser there.
Hello? Oh, Pete! Oh, how are you doing? Yeah, thanks for the call. Yeah, thanks very much. Fair play to you. Thanks. Pete McCarran.
I told you.
It on the radio too.
I told you. Christy, what did we do with the winnings?
Well, I've decided that I'll send the money that I found in the old man's jacket to the lads in America. So the winnings we can spend on the house.
Yeah, we could do with a bit of work, all right, yeah. And then, if we do that, what are we going to live on?
Well, I was thinking that maybe I'd write a book about the whole experience. What do you think?
Oh, no. I don't know.
You look tired, Ava.
Oh, yeah, Christy. I am tired. I found that journey up and down to Dublin very tiring. Oh, do you know, Christy? I think I'm pregnant.
How could you be pregnant?
Oh, I'm almost certain.
How the fuck could you be pregnant? What the fuck am I using condoms for?
Well, now, Christy Kelly, I didn't get pregnant on my own.
What a day to spoil everything for the club, or for us. I know this might sound horrible, but we said we wouldn't.
I know, Christy, I know we said we wouldn't.
How sure are we?
90%.
Get it checked again. It couldn't be mine. Are you seeing someone else?
How could you be so cruel and say something like that to me, Christy?
You are. Hello? Who? What? Father who? Father Willie? Here, this must be for you.
Thanks. Oh, hello? Hello, Father Willie. Yeah. Oh, God, thanks. Yeah, that was Christy you were talking to. Oh, we're very pleased. It was great news. Yeah. I'll tell him that. Okay, thanks very much now, Father Willie. Talk again. Bye-bye.
What the fuck is?
What, Christy?
We're very pleased. It's great news. Did you tell the priest?
Tell the priest what?
That you're pregnant.
And for God's sake, Christy, will you cop on? He was ringing to tell us to congratulate us about the great win. He heard it at Mass this morning. Seemingly he's been on the radio all morning about us. Will I try it and put it on?
I'll try it. Yeah.
Good morning. It's 11 o'clock on Midland 108 to 109. The news with Pam Cotter. The village of Culliandra is this morning celebrating a national award. Local couple Christy Kelly and Ava Hoey have just won first prize in the All-Ireland Clean, Lean and Green competition run by the Department of the Environment. The couple, who don't have a family, have only recently moved back to live in Beggan.
Very appropriate news. The couple who don't have a family. I hear me name on that fucking radio.
Now, Christy, let's not confuse these two issues. Winning that national award was a phenomenal achievement and something that we should be very proud of. The pregnancy, if it's confirmed, well, we just have to live with it. And I'm very sorry that you think I am more responsible for this than you.
It's not that, Ava. It's just that it's not what we planned. It's...
Christy, please calm down. Do you know what I was thinking? It was a little girl. Sure, maybe we call her Lily after your mammy.
Maybe.
Where are you going now, Christy?
I'm going out to milk this cow.
I see it's hard to shift your stuff today. And not sight nor light of the priest to be seen. Not sight nor light of him.
Oh, I know, Megs. God, it's much quieter than usual. And you know, I've missed a few weeks myself.
I see the crow and cock put the going on Christy.
I didn't think you'd notice.
You must be about 5 months gone. And showing a fair bit.
Well, about that, Megs, do you know, but I didn't honestly think it was that noticeable at this stage. Do you know something, Megs? This place used to be great when we first started coming here. It's got so quiet now.
So the priest used to buy all your stuff. I say he used to buy nearly all your stuff.
He used to. I haven't seen him today, did you?
No, never seen sight nor light of him. You know, the saying he's gone horror queer lately. Used to be a great man for socialising. A great man for the women.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah, a great man for the women. But a great priest. I hear he's leaving.
Is he leaving the priesthood?
Jeez, not at all. No, he's leaving the parish. I say the parish.
Oh, Jesus, I'd miss him if he wasn't around.
Look, there he is.
Mum,
you're over here,
Fanny.
I see him.
Oh, Mags. Ava. How are you both?
Great.
Hello, Fanny.
And,
how's it going?
I'm
I hear you're leaving us.
That's only a rumour, Mags. Oh. How could I leave people like you?
Oh, dear, I suppose. Well, I'll let you go at your business, and I'll go to my business. Mrs. P. Mrs. Colby.
Willie, I've missed you so much. Have you been keeping okay?
Oh, Ava, it's been so difficult. Listen, how sure are you?
Well, I'm pretty certain now, Willie.
No, Ava, I mean, the father.
Sure, it has to be your baby. Do you remember you saying that night? You wouldn't use protection. It was against your religion. Oh, not too bad at the moment, you know. I've nearly convinced that he's the feather. But, you know, the big win and all that has sort of kept him busy of late.
Now, it's important for the moment you keep my name out of it. That'll be too much for us to deal with.
Oh, do you know, Willie, we were both so silly on that night.
Look, Ava, I was silly. I mean, I should have known.
Oh, but, you know, I just don't think it was that night. I think the first time we met here, we were attracted to each other.
It's just such a huge dilemma for me, Ava. You know I love my work. You know I love the church.
I do, but you've got to put your little baby first.
It's just such a huge dilemma.
Oh, Willie, you know I want to be close to you. You know that.
Well, I do too, Ava. You know, and I keep praying.
Oh, praying for what?
Well, you know, Ava, sometimes it's hard for the church to please everyone.
Willie, I want us to have this baby and for us to live together, and that's what I want, and I think you want the same.
Listen, I see Mrs. Hickey coming down. Listen, I will go to the party, and from anyway, there's a few market days between now and then. Joe, I nearly forgot where you're. I'll take the usual.
I have it all here for you, and then I'll put it out the basket. Here too.
Thanks, Smith. We'll talk to you soon.
We will.
How are you doing there, Charlie? Good to see you pass out on Sunday.
Tea for me, dear.
I have, love. God, the evening's moving on. Christy, it won't be long till the guests start arriving.
Couldn't tell you about me surprise visitor from America.
Oh, Lord, please don't tell me it's your wife.
Oh, nearly as bad. It's me eldest lad, Patrick. I should never have told him about the winnings, you know. She probably sent him over for the money.
Well, do you know, I'd like to know when you found out all of this.
I met Pete McCartan there on the road. He told me his eldest lad was going up to get him at the bus stop. They're always great mates. He's staying with the McCartans.
But sure, I thought the McCartans were coming here tonight.
Oh, Jesus, the McCartans will be here tonight. So they're great neighbours and great party people. Don't fret that.
Well, do you know now something, Christy? I hope Patrick doesn't cause any trouble here tonight. He was never very nice to me when we spoke on the phone. I think he blamed me for the breakup of your marriage.
So you know that's not the case. Don't you worry one bit about him. I'll handle him.
You take it easy on that drink, too.
I'll be fine.
Do you know something, Christian? Everything has changed for us.
You mean with the baby?
Yeah. I just hope it all works out for everyone concerned.
What do you mean, Ava, for everyone concerned?
It's just not as straightforward as you think now.
You mean with my family?
I mean, yeah, that's what I mean.
I see the bump is getting quite noticeable now at the minute.
Oh, sure, I know, Christian.
Oh, that's what I dread about tonight. I'm going to be the centre of attention, and it scares me.
You know what I'll do now? I'll go out and tidy up and do a few jobs before they come for the pan. Get the lights up. So you just mind it, okay, right?
Oh.
There'll not be a bother, Miss Yarn.
Look at you. You look fabulous as always.
I can't believe this.
What, my bump?
I never thought I'd see the day. You used to say I'd never get caught like that.
Well, I'm well and surely caught now.
So how is everyone with it?
Oh, it's a bit scary, really, Gina. Like, Christy's sort of accepting it, and Willie.
You mean the priest?
Yeah, Father Willie. Well, he knows he's the father, but he doesn't know what to do about it.
Oh, from the test.
Oh, yeah, the test proved it. Did you see Christy outside?
Oh, I did.
And how was he? You know how he can be so abrupt.
Oh, he just said go ahead on in. He'd be in a few minutes. Not overly polite. But you know, I've always been a little on edge with him.
Oh, sure, I know that, Darren. Here, give me your jacket. Darren, and will you have a glass of wine?
Yeah. I must say, Ava, the place is looking great.
Oh, yeah.
And the gardens outside are gorgeous.
Oh, but you know something, Gina? I'm so used to it now.
And winning that national award, that was some achievement.
Oh,
you must be so proud.
It was. It was great. But, you know, it just doesn't seem the same anymore.
So who's coming to this party tonight?
Oh, look, a few of the locals. They're all really lovely people.
And the priest?
Yeah, Willie. Yeah, I hope he'll be here. I want him to come.
You're obviously in love with him, and it's not Christy anymore.
Yeah, Gina, but I really have to put in a big effort tonight.
Well, you know, he'd never leave the priesthood for you.
Oh, no, no. That's the problem with the church. They've great men like Willie who fall in love, still want to be priests.
Well, you know, we don't go to church anymore.
Oh, no, neither do we, but I was genuinely putting in a big effort and then this. So anyways, that put an end to that, Gina. Listen, could I ask you a favour?
Yeah.
Would you take me down the town? I just need to get a few last bits for the party.
Okay,
thanks.
I'll give you a spin on your car.
You got here, Patrick.
Okay.
She sent you over for the money. And I thought she'd come over here to see me. How wrong was I?
Is that what it looks like, Dad?
It looks like it to me. I'll tell you what you'll do now, me boy. Get yourself up here and gather yourself and get you to fuck out of here and back to America. I never want to see one of yous again.
Yes.
He used to get Patrick to sing it. Jizzy love.
What about someone else for a song? What about you, Trina? Will you give it a lash?
Or everyone would leave if I started to sing.
Well, Jizzy, I often heard you singing late at night.
Well, maybe later. They'll leave me to later.
Well, Christy, what about yourself there for a song? You were, when you were a young lad, you had a grand voice.
Jesus, when I was a young lad, that's a while ago. I see he's looking at photographs there of the award scheme for the national awards job that we were involved in. What can I say? On behalf of myself and Ava, I'd like to invite you all here to our little celebration tonight. Don't be shy now, eat and drink up. Gina here, Ava's sister, will keep you fed and watered. Ava, will you get that? It's been a roller coaster 7 or 8 years, what with old jaunty Kelly there, Lord of Mercy, and my father dying suddenly, my family situation back in the States, and of course now that I've moved back here and settled in with Ava in the home place.
Father Willie, you probably know most of these people.
Well, I'd certainly recognise most of the faces anyway.
Well, there's Jimmy Harris. Very kind neighbour to myself and Christy.
Look, I'd know Jimmy now. Jimmy, I'd see him on the road. It's very nice to meet you, Jimmy.
Nice to meet you, sir.
Yeah, and there's Pete and Trina McCarroll. You probably know them.
Well, Trina's always at Mass.
She was talking to you this evening after Mass, Father.
And do you know Mags Monaghan?
Sure, who doesn't know Mags? It's nice to see you, Mags.
And there's Mick Jean Brady, another great neighbour of ours as well.
There's a man I never remember seeing at Mass.
Father took the soup a few years ago.
What did you say, Mixie?
They took the soup, there, you know.
And this is my sister, Gina.
Oh, it's pleased to meet you.
I've heard a lot about you now. I wouldn't necessarily connect you as sisters.
I'm the younger one.
And then this is my partner, Christopher.
Oh, pleased to meet you, Christopher.
You too, Father. Gina here will keep you fed and watered.
Oh, thanks, amazing.
Oh, Gina, Father Willie likes red wine.
Well, this is fine.
No. I have a special bottle of Australian from the market kept for me.
Would you like something yourself?
A little.
Go on, Christy. Now, can we continue our speech there?
Well, no, thanks. I wouldn't call it a speech. Where was it? We landed back here, myself and Ava, with a couple of €100. And in fairness, with the help of our neighbours, especially Jimmy here and his good wife, Flory, we entered a national scheme. And so, we gave it a good shot. Oh, fuck it, we gave it better than a good shot we wanted, man. And I know that my partner Ava here enjoyed the whole experience and met a lot of interesting people along the way, particularly at the Friday markets. Ava, would you like to say a few words?
No, Christy. I'd be too shy. You carry on. You're doing good.
What about himself?
Who?
Oh, Father Willie. He's a great man to talk.
Well, thanks for asking me, Max. Well, on behalf of everyone here, and indeed the people of the entire parish, I'd like to congratulate you both on your great achievement. And so with the club winning the junior championship and now with Christy and Ava winning the national award, it's been a great, great year for the parish.
Hear, hear.
Now, I haven't met Christy before tonight, but I have got to know Ava very well through the farmers' markets, and indeed I spent a lovely night here. I spent a lovely night here the night we blessed the house. I mean, the night I blessed the house.
Aye, the only night I was ever away.
Oh, yeah. He seemed to have blessed more than the fucking house be the last time.
What nice.
Do you know, that was getting tricky. Oh, do you know, I'm frightened. What are we going to do?
No, we'll soon have to decide what's best.
We will, because, you know, I heard Christy out there in the air saying to a neighbour when they were congratulating him about the baby. Oh, what he said was horrible.
What was that?
Oh, he said, we never planned this, but we're stuck with it now.
It's not very nice.
Well, neither did we.
Leave them to bring what, Heather?
Pledge.
You're able to keep praying.
Oh, but know something. I am stuck. I'm sick of praying, and I'm stuck with this baby that neither you nor Christian knows what to do with. I'm sick to the pit of my stomach.
Listen, I will do.
Listen, I forgot to mention it earlier. If any of you want to use the toilet, you know it's outside, but it's on the door front end the door you just come in. There's torches there on the dresser. What about someone else from a bedroom and out too?
Well, if you want now, Chris, I can give you a bar or two of Loch Sheelan or some of them.
Have I? Any tune is here now for me old friend and neighbour Jimmy House.
If ever I... that's too high, I think. If ever I leave this land of mine and journey across the sea, one little spot I'll always pine, the one place I long to be. Oh, the mountains of Mourne are grand, I know, as up to the heavens they soar. But my heart will not be by mountain or sea, oh no, but down by Loch Sheelan shore. For her beauty steals my breath away every hour of the day, when the sun is dancing o'er in the moonlight. Down by Loch Sheelan's sandy shore, my heart will always be. I can't remember any more, but...
It's no fault of the company now, but I leave you to it.
Oh, Mass in the morning, Father, is it?
That's right, Ava. I've early Mass in the morning. Enjoy your night, everyone.
Good night, Father.
Nice meeting you, Father.
A lovely priest.
Oh, he's a queer boy, that fair Father Willie, a queer boy.
Get back to the party, them priests, huh? What about someone else? Is there anyone else there going to give it a lash?
What about Pete?
You used to have an instrument 5 years ago, didn't you? Played a whistle or something.
Oh, my God, you were a topper I had, Pete. And you know, there's an old whistle at Johnty's there, I think it's in the dress or somewhere.
It's still here because I was only rooting in it other day. Here she is.
Give us a shot, has it?
Give us a crack.
Strange to see how times have changed of late. Coercion now is all the row, with peelers on their bait. Or to raise a glass, now it is, alas, the greatest crime of all, since Balfour placed that hungry bit, the sergeant from Grouse Hall. Now he'd run pell-mell down into hell, just to search for poaching there. Oh, indeed he'd not be loath to swear an oath, they found it in Killinkere. And he'd search the bed from toe to head, sheets, blankets, ticks and all, and your wife undressed must leave the nest for Jemmy from Grouse Hall.
You're next, Max.
Oh, I haven't an oath in me fucking head. I wonder if you'd get an oath in the bank.
Well, any sign of Ava?
Oh, yeah, she's just chatting with the priest outside.
Some fucking hostess.
Oh, some fucking priest. he's probably blessing her again.
I tell you, it's in here organising this party, should be. Now, fuck that! I'll put fucking manners on them!
You know, Christy Kelly's a very funny man. He He's all right when he's sober. By God, he's a changed man when he has drank to him.
Well, I'll tell you, he didn't look that fucking funny looking when he was leaving. I say he wasn't that funny looking.
Pete, look at, he's probably just gone out there to rap on the door or something. Pete, maybe, you know, while we're waiting, give us another tune on that joke, aren't you? By the time he comes back, the whole thing will be settled.
Aye, maybe.
I know you from your regards. In fact, to myself and Flory, you were like the gossip that we never had. Don't go away on us again, Christy. Don't leave us again. Remember, Christy, that you always have myself and Flory here. No matter what happens, Christy.